So why you make a decision to launch this project in Wuhan City?
We chose Wuhan initially in 2017 because Wuhan is a city where there is a lot of talents, thanks to a lot of universities and a very strong expertise in science and technology. And also at that time, we see that the struggle for talents is true everywhere in China because of the very fast development of the country. But we still want to develop here and capitalize on the extraordinary teams that we have here.
So what's the future development plan for the software center here?
The software in the car is becoming more and more essential. The car is becoming more intelligent in this autonomous way of functioning, but as well a lot of systems that become intelligent, like the thermal system, the lighting systems. So this is why we need more and more software capabilities in China. And this is why we want to expand further this software center that we first established here in Wuhan in 2017, expanded the first time in 2019, and then gives a second round of expansion so that it has now the capability to support all the Valeo China operations in terms of software.
Any other measurements Valeo will take to accelerate the local R&D center?
Yes, the group has decided to launch a couple of initiatives to boost innovation in China, in all our operations, in all our development centers. So the first thing we are going to do is we are going to launch a new batch of innovation projects to address not only the market in China, but can also have some global impact. The second is that we are very proud to launch a new innovation and mobility center, which we have a front office in Beijing. We have also set up here in Wuhan in the beginning of the year, what we call a car lab to focus on user experience.
我们看到就是法料在中国的这个本地化研发其实做了非常大的投入，那有没有一些就是由中国团队这个自主研发，但是被全球市场所应用的一些case呢？我们在车灯模组当中有一个叫超薄透镜模组啊，叫G3的这样一个模组，就是由中国团队开发，然后呢，它会先在中国我们跟某一个自主品牌马上要量产，然后接下来会在欧洲有不同的项目也会量产。
我们看到现在其实汽车行业的竞争确实日趋激烈，法料怎么样来保持就是这方面的这个领先性，来应对这样的这个白热化的竞争？举个例子，我们在中国其实法料产品有最广泛的我们叫传感器的组合，从2020年到现在，在全球推出的有 L3 级别自动驾驶的车辆，我们举个例子哈，其中这两款车型，它们的共同一点就是都使用了法料的激光雷达。那么法料的激光雷达是行业内第一个车规级的量产的激光雷达。我们在中国还有很多的量产项目，同时我们还会跟一些科技公司和初创企业进行开放性的合作，开放性的创新的合作。所以这些都是我们在中国保持竞争力的一个方法。
这是第一次法料中国就是向公众展示CarLab这个概念，能不能请您再详细介绍一下？那
CarLab 的中文名字叫汽车实验室啊，但它其实不仅仅是一个实验室，也是一个团队，更是一个以用户为中心的创新的一种方法。那简单的讲，就是我们通过了解客户的使用习惯和使用痛点，那么我们通过脑力激荡、头脑风暴这些方法来提出一些新的概念设计。 然后通过像这种快速样件，在我们的实验室内用模拟器的方法来验证、来选择这样一个迭代方法，这种创新的方法就叫这个所谓的 Car Lab。那么我们在中国这是第一个 Car Lab，我们把它建在武汉的技术中心，但是它是会向全中国的所有的研发中心开放，同时也会向我们的对外的合作伙伴开放。
科技驱动。